Thank you. What's happening, Melbourne? How's everybody doing? All right? All right.
Chris Bullock on the saxophone.
Chris McQueen on the electric guitar. Bobby Sparks on the organ and the rhythm. Mike Mazmaher on the trumpet. And you'll meet the rest of the dudes in a minute. It's so good to be back. It's been so many years. My God, too many years. Six, 7 years. Five, six, unacceptable. Regardless, we'll never do it again. And so wonderful to be back in this room. I was talking with my friend Melanie, who is the director for the Melbourne International Jazz Festival, who brought us here over a decade ago, I think it was, for the first time, where we played this little back room of this little jazz club. You know, and I think none of us and none of them were expecting us to sell more than like 10 tickets, and I think we sold like 12. So they asked us to play another night and in that little club, and then, you know, now to be here is really, it's really wonderful to come back to this, like our little home in Melbourne, the Forum, what a beautiful room. Sculptures of our distant relatives over there, or whatever. We're playing a lot of new music tonight, new music, from a record that came out last year called Empire Central, that's dedicated to Dallas and Texas kind of at large, this band, although there are a lot of non-Texans in the band. It was formed in Texas, and that record is really just about giving it up for Texas's incredibly rich musical culture and legacy and history. You know, a lot of you listen to Texas musicians without knowing they're Texas musicians, maybe like people maybe more famous like Beyonce and Usher, Texans, you know, whatever, but also it's like going all the way back to like Blindlin and Jefferson, the kings of the blues, you know, also people like Janis Joplin and Roy Hargrove, and you know, I mean, the list kind of goes on and on. Robert Glasper, Chris Day, Jason Moran, Eric Harlan, Kendrick Scott, you know, it's like the list is kind of intense. And this record was really just about saying thanks to them, and we're gonna play a bunch of music from that tonight, but now that I've said all that, we're gonna play a song that has nothing to do with that record. From a record in 2016 called Culture Vulture, we're gonna show off our percussionist, Nate Worth, back there. Say hey to Nate. The song's called Cementi. Thank you.
See, I don't really like to scream that much. I like to like just kind of whisper at you.
Where?
Robbie Spice on the clavinet. Mike Mazmar's tall ass on vocals. That's Jameson Ross back there on the drum set, Melbourne.
Those last couple were songs from the new record. We're gonna play another one now. We got a couple more for you. This one is was written for and about an incredible musician who had more of an impact on this band than any other musician on earth, living or dead, I would say. A guy by the name of Bernard Wright. Okay, I'm very, very happy to hear that some people have heard of Bernard because he somehow managed to stay under the radar, even though he grew up with some of the greatest music. He was like, grew up with Lenny White and Marcus Miller and Jamaica Queens, New York, and played with Stevie Wonder and Chaka Khan. Roberta Flack was his godmother. You know, he grew up in this incredible cradle of music, and actually, you know, was so multi-talented. There was a moment where he was kind of, didn't really know what to do because he was so able to do so many things at such a high level. He actually had one of the first black music videos on MTV in the 80s with a song called Who Do You Love that actually some of you might know. Incredible artist, and just by chance we crossed paths, and he played in the band for a few years and kind of left a huge mark on the band. And then we didn't play together for like 10 years, and then when we came back to make this record in Dallas, he called me and said, like, I heard y'all are coming, I wanna show up at the recording session. So he said, well, we already have 680 people in the band, so 681 is not a big deal. So he came and played on a couple songs, including that last song that we just did, which was called Take It by Bobby Sparks. Which, by the way, the band heard for the first time in 2006 on MySpace. Bobby's kind of demo for that song before we even met Bobby. And so Bernard played a huge role in this band. He played on the record, and you know, he was a big unifier of the music scene in Dallas. You know, Erykah Badu and all of her people are from there, Kirk Franklin and all of his people are from there, and Bernard had this Monday night gig where all the musicians in Dallas would come out and kind of worship at the altar of Bernard Wright. And then a couple months after the recording, he was just suddenly and unexpectedly hit by a car and died. It was the strangest, craziest, most tragic thing, and a huge loss for music and for the Texas community and definitely for this band. And so this is a song that I wrote for him before he passed, about how he pulled the community together on this street called Belmont Avenue. But I guess now that he's not here, it means even more. So this one is and will always be for Bernard Wright. And if you don't know Bernard, don't know his music, please do yourselves a favor. I feel like if we don't do anything else in our careers, hopefully we can at least expose people to his musical legacy. Bernard Wright, the first record he made when he was 14 is called Nard, with Marcus and Lenny White and Buster Williams and Roy Haynes. And it's like an incredible record that Snoop Dogg sampled and LL Cool J sampled, all this stuff when he was 14. Nard is the name of the record, so please check that out. Do some homework for us, if you don't mind. This song is called Belmont. Thank you. Before we go, how about a hand for Chris Bullock on the flute and the saxophone? On the trumpet and the flugelhorn, show your love for Jay Jennings. Guitar from Austin, Texas, Chris McQueen. On keyboards and trumpet, that's Justin Stanton.
keyboards from Corsicana, Texas, the one, the only, Bobby Sparks. On percussion, back there, that's Nate Worth. On drums back there, Mr. Jameson Ross. And how about an extra special hand for the Snarky Puppy crew, especially Mike Harrison behind the soundboard, Claire McInerney on lights, Ryan Haft on our sound, Mason Davis solving problems, Rosanna Friedman and Crook Stewart babysitting us. Thank you all. My name is Michael Lee, we're Snarky Puppy. It's been so much fun being with you tonight, Bob, and thanks for being here. We really appreciate it. Thank you. Thank y'all so much. It's very sweet of you, thank you. Hope you had fun tonight. We definitely did. Kind of a crazy thing to go as far as you can physically go on this earth away from where you grew up and play music for people and they listen, and that's an incredible thing. So we're very grateful to you all, not only for coming here is very important also, but just to have a room full of people who are listening and making sure that they notice every mistake we make. It's really wonderful. It's incredible to play for a crowd of people with big ears. So thank you very much for giving us that energy and that attention. We appreciate that very much. We're going to finish with an old one, kind of. That, my friend. You were born in 2010. No, just kidding. So were we. Don't ask questions. Here we go, right? For Jay Jennings. Thank you.
Thank you all so much. One more time, Jameson Ross, Nate Worth, Chris McQueen, Bobby Sparks, Justin Stanton, Mike Maher, Jay Jennings, Chris Bullock, and Snuggy Puppy. Thank you so much. Y'all are wonderful. Thank you. If you have been signing stuff, come say hey.